development in a developing country like India necessitates such plans and working procedures that are not only supportive but also inspirational. In developing nations, while individual efforts can succeed only if large amounts of resources are employed, cooperative efforts turn out to be gainful even when communities work on limited resources. Cooperation is not a novel idea in India. This principle is intrinsic to rural life. That's why cooperation serves as a very effective tool for development in India. Keeping this in view, the Indian Parliament constituted the National Cooperative Development Corporation, or NCDC, under an Act of 1962. In rural areas, through the medium of cooperatives, NCDC works for production, processing, distribution, storage, import and export of agricultural products and services related to food products and some other important goods. Besides, it promotes cooperative programs, supports the cooperative committees, and constantly works towards encouraging and developing them. In order to maximize its support to the cooperatives, the corporation has time and again made changes in its working procedures. On the basis of cooperative development, the states of the country have been categorized into developed states, underdeveloped states, and least developed states. Financial support is extended to the underdeveloped states and least developed states on liberal terms so that they can be partners in the country's balanced growth. The financial assistance of NCDC to cooperative societies and programs happens through and with the guarantee of the state government. Eligible cooperative societies can obtain even direct financial assistance under various schemes. Subsidy is also a component of NCDC's financial assistance. India is an agriculture-centric country. Agriculture is the mainstay of our economy. It is the occupation of most of the population. The corporation provides financial assistance to various states through cooperatives to procure agricultural produce. This helps the farmers in getting appropriate and timely prices for their produce. The produce purchased at appropriate prices by various states reaches out to consumers all over the nation. The corporation works for fulfilling every requirement of agricultural activities, including funding, technical support, human resource development, and evaluation. Another principal work of NCDC is to develop post-harvest management infrastructure for the agricultural produce. Financial assistance is also extended to various cooperative societies involved in storage and cold storage of agricultural and other food products. The new storage policy of the Government of India envisages the corporation as a partner. The corporation is extending financial assistance to augment the storage capacity of the country at various levels so that the post-harvest losses could be minimized. Besides, on the basis of the receipt that one's produce has been stored in the godown, a farmer can raise loans, and later, on getting better prices of the produce, the farmer can make more gains. Apart from cultivation, the corporation is also involved with other agriculture-related activities. This includes processing units such as sugar mills and handloom mills. Sugar is the second largest agricultural industry of the nation. The corporation provides financial assistance to cooperatives for setting up and development of sugar mills. These activities enable meeting the sugar requirements of the nation easily. Consequently, the employment opportunities increase for rural populace, which in turn makes the grower involved with sugar mills financially prosperous. The entire community and area witnesses social, financial, and educational development. The sugar mills also extend support to activities such as irrigation, road construction, education, and healthcare. production of byproducts of sugarcane, such as alcohol, also gets a boost. Dairy industry is a means of earning income and provides employment for countless rural families. Right from the time it was established, the corporation has been encouraging and supporting dairy cooperatives. Understandably, the corporation had a major role in white revolution. At the community level, the greatest advantage of the dairy industry is that farmers get opportunities for extra income all through the year. Cooperative societies provide mobile animal treatment centers for the dairy industry. Also, dairy industry is supported with programs on artificial insemination and fodder growth. The dairies run by these societies, on the one hand, facilitate financial growth of farmers. On the other, they ensure that consumers get quality milk at reasonable prices. NCDC is involved with every aspect of the production of the country's natural products in one way or the other. 8,118 kilometers of India's land territory is adjoined by sea, and 73.59 lakh hectares is adjoined by inland water areas. For those living in coastal areas, fish and other sea products constitute a major source of income. The cooperative societies of fishermen are provided financial assistance by NCDC for purchase of motorized boats and fishing nets for catching fish. Support is also provided for post-fishing activities like distribution, storage and cold storage. Besides, the cooperative societies are also helped to set up fish processing units. Cooperative societies also work to provide fishing equipment to fishermen at reasonable prices through their stores. The corporation aims to support the socially backward classes and works towards their development and financial self-reliance. The corporation undertakes various activities for this purpose. One such activity is to provide support to the handloom industry. Due to limited base and resources, the handloom industry ran into mismanagement. NCDC has provided substantial financial assistance in the areas of handloom and powerloom. Financial assistance is provided to weaker sections, and this segment was encouraged to grow. By providing technical support, making of those kinds of designs was facilitated, which earlier were difficult to devise. New opportunities were created for weavers in the international markets, and new markets were also created. In the northeastern states, handicrafts happen to be the business and source of income of every household. Facilitation of coloring of dresses also colored the lives of people. Through its various activities, NCDC also provides financial assistance for the sale of consumer items. The NCDC assisted cooperative societies have virtually redefined the markets. The goods for daily consumption in Kerala are made available through water routes. The cooperative societies provide goods for daily consumption at reasonable prices. In the northeastern states, cooperative consumer stores are running very well, even in the most remote areas. The success of the initiatives of NCDC can be gauged from the fact that in several states, cooperative bazaars of various sizes have been set up so that quality products could be made available to the consumers at reasonable prices. In order to enhance participation in the growth process, the corporation has formulated Integrated Cooperative Development Plan, or ICDP. ICDP works for comprehensive development in selected districts by keeping in mind the rural needs and resources. It supports the formulated plans and through cooperatives helps in implementation of these plans. In the past two decades, the society has witnessed widespread transitions. These transitions have triggered big changes in the government plans and the needs and expectations of the agriculture-dependent rural populace. In view of this, corresponding changes in the work procedures and work plans of NCTC were also required to be undertaken. Therefore, the corporation has expanded its activities to the spheres of tourism, power, rural housing, health and education. The prosperity and development of a nation is dependent upon the conditions of its women and their state of development. In order to empower women in the field of agriculture, the Government of India has stressed on the need of appropriate institutional ways. Need has also been expressed to provide financial services to women through formal banking system under the national plan. The corporation encourages the women cooperatives to secure financial assistance under its various schemes. Human Resource Development or HRD is an intrinsic part of cooperation. In order to meet the HRD needs of the cooperatives, a training institute has been set up at Gurgaon with the name Topic Institute. This institute meets the training needs of the principal workers of the cooperative societies and also runs several promotional and developmental schemes. In order to make its changing role all the more useful to the society, the corporation has started its CSR or Corporate Social Responsibility Program. Under this program, the corporation undertakes several activities all over the country. Apart from facilitating skill development and production works, these activities also aid social progress. In view of its increased working areas and responsibilities, the corporation has set up partnerships with several national and international organizations. Since 2002, the National Cooperative Development Corporation is conferring the Cooperative Excellence Award every 2 years to primary cooperative committees for excellent performance. Due to the constant efforts of NCDC, the Indian cooperative movement has made substantial and effective strides. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, and from Gujarat to Bengal, today there are more than 6 lakh cooperative societies in the nation. The entire world today recognizes the Indian cooperative movement, in which the corporation has had a major role to play. NCDC is absolutely committed to the true development of the nation by continually strengthening the Indian cooperative movement.